Hello, good day, Sir Howard here. Welcome sa ating panibagong series on Libreng Sit-In where we are going to talk about psychometrics. Napakahalaga na subject ito, lalong-lalo na it is one of the board exam subjects. So I hope this series of lectures about psychometrics may help you kung meron kayong planong mag-board exam or you are just simply curious about the field of psychometrics. So for this episode, simple lang ang gagawin natin. I am going to simply set the context why a psych major like you would be interested in psychometrics. Now, let me just open this discussion or this lecture by asking you, why should a psych major be good in psychometrics? Alam nyo, kung merong isang subject na sa tingin ko, ang isang psych major dapat maging magaling, I would say one of the subjects would be psychometrics. Kapag psych major ka, dapat yung iyong competence on psychometrics must be above average. Hindi pwedeng average lang. Lalong-lalo na hindi pwedeng below average because this is a very important subject or skill set of being a psych major or in the future, being a psychology professional. Now, to be more specific, sa tingin ko, there are two reasons kung bakit mahalaga na ma-master ng isang psych major yung subject na psychometrics. Number one, because mastering this field will be the trademark or the trademark is the trademark of being a psychology professional. Let me ask you, what makes you professionally unique? Or in other words, what makes being a psychology professional unique? Ano yung isang bagay na ang isang psych major lang o isang psychology professional lang ang kayang gumawa? Diba? That's a very good question. Kasi bawat profession that we can think of, they have something unique to offer in the field. So ikaw, bilang isang psychologist, bilang isang psychology professional, ano ang unique sa'yo? Dahil ikaw ay professional psychologist, what is this something that only you can do? Many people would say, magaling ako sa counseling skills. Kaya nga ako psych major because I am good in giving advices. Now, the problem here is counseling is not a unique skill set for being a psych professional or being a psych major. Marami pang ibang mga tao dyan na hindi naman psychology professionals but yet, they are very good in counseling. They do counseling. For example, in the media, uso yan. Marami mga DJs ngayon, both AM and FM, they are giving counseling on air. And a lot of these DJs are not even psychology majors and yet they do counseling. But in all fairness to them, some of them make sense. Marami rin naman mga DJs na magaling mag-counseling, pero hindi lahat, no? Oo, hindi lahat. Pero mayroong talagang iba, magaling naman talaga sa counseling. So the point here is, counseling, it's not a unique skill that only psych majors can do. So kung hindi counseling, maybe research. After all, di ba? Ang psychology, you graduate from psychology by doing research. So, can you say that it is only psych majors who do research? Is this the skill that we can uniquely offer to the field? The answer is no. Kasi maraming mga field of knowledge out there that also do research. They do research in history. They do research in mass media or even in the field of the arts. Meron silang tinatawag na creative research. In fact, hindi ko lang nailagay dito, meron ding philosophical research. O, di ba? So, the point here again is, research is not a unique skill set that a psych major can give to the field. Maraming ibang mga fields, they also do research. Maybe people skills. Di ba? Kasi dahil psych major ako, graduate ako ng psychology, I am good with people skills. Can we say that only psych majors ang merong people skills? I would say no. There are many people out there, they are not even psych majors, and yet, they are good in people skills. They are so good in persuading people. They are so good in getting people's support. Question, are they psych majors? Hindi. Diba? Especially politicians. Diba? Marami mga politicians, they are so gifted in influencing people. They are so gifted in making people believe that they are the right leaders in a position and people believe them. Oh, pero hindi naman sila mga psych majors, 'di ba? So the point here again is people skills is not a unique skill set that only psych majors can offer. So, ang tanong ngayon, ano nga? So, hindi counseling, hindi research, hindi people skills. The answer is, what makes a psychology professional or a psych major unique? Your ability to construct, use, and understand psychological tests, tayo lang ang may kaya niyan. Hindi kaya yan ng isang history major, hindi kaya ito ng isang philosophy major. Again, let me repeat, only psych majors have the ability to construct, use, and understand psychological tests. This is one of the things that we can be proud of, na talagang tayo lang ang may kayang gumawa. So it's very important that you master this subject because this is what will make you professionally unique over other professions. Number two, mahalaga na pag-aralan ng psychometrics because in the future, when you begin to practice psychology, this will give you credibility. Kailan ba tayo nakakakuha ng credibility? When we have a basis to the things that we say. So when we say something, those words that we say becomes credible kapag meron siyang backup na basis. Parang ano lang yan eh, parang mga doktor lang yan, di ba? Ang isang doktor, pag sinabihan kang meron kang lung cancer, that's a statement coming from a doctor, ano ang basis ng isang doctor to support the statement you have lung cancer? Marami. Merong blood test, merong x-ray, merong MRI, and all the other medical tests. Yan ang kanyang magiging basis for saying that someone has lung cancer. Ganun din naman sa pag-aabogado. If a lawyer, for example, claims that this person needs to go to jail, kailangan ikulong itong taong ito, ano ang basis ng isang abogado to say that? The answer, evidence. Kaya nga kapag naglo-lawyer ka, if you are studying law, dapat master mo how evidence works. There is a process. How will you present evidence? How will you prove that your evidence is true? How will you prove that the evidence is trustworthy? Diba? Kasi yan yung magiging basis ng mga statement ng isang abogado. It's all about legal evidence. The same thing with being a psychologist. Bilang isang psikolohista in the future, you are going to make psychological statements about people. Let's say you will say that John is intellectually challenged, Jenny is having adjustment problems, or Eric has schizophrenia. These are psychological statements. But if people ask you, ano ang basehan mo? Paano mo nasabi yung mga statements na yan? Your answer would be, everything that you've said is based on what you saw from the use of different psychological tests. O diba, kapag nagsabi ka ng mga psychological statements na wala ka namang basis, then that becomes a questionable statement. In fact, yung pagiging professional mo also becomes questionable. Kasi hindi pwedeng gagawa ka lang ng statement without any basis. So when you study psychometrics, you are learning how to justify what you will say in the future in relation to your profession. When you make statements about the human mind, how it works, what's wrong with it, ano ang ebidensya mo, ano ang backup mo to make those statements, the answer, what psychological tests will report to you. So, let me just add one more bonus reason kung bakit kinakailangan mong maging magaling sa psychometrics as a psych major is, you know, this is where the cash flow is in the field of psychology. Don't get me wrong, hindi ko sinasabing walang cash flow in other fields in psychology. Definitely meron. But I am focusing more on psychometrics. Why am I able to say na merong cash flow in psychometrics? Because if you realize, almost everything that you do in psychometrics, you can get paid. Kada galaw mo, pwede kang bayaran eh. For example, pwede kang bayaran simply for administering a test. Pwede kang bayaran for scoring the test. Iba pa yung bayad sa pag-interpret ng test. Iba pa yung bayad sa pag-construct ng test. So imagine kung lahat yan kaya mong gawin, then definitely there will be cash flow. Okay, so hindi ko naman sinasabi na dito lang ang cash flow, no? Sa psychology, there are also other fields na may cash flow. But then again, as I've mentioned, I am focusing on psychometrics kasi yun ang ating pinag-aaralan ngayon. And what can we learn from here? Almost everything that you do, the smallest thing that you do in this field, you can be paid for doing it. All right? So I hope yan ay makadagdag ng motivation sa inyo to master the field of psychometrics. Before we end this video, let me just share with you my closing thoughts sa ating maikling pag-uusap ngayon. Number one, I hope you realize doing psychometrics is a very important skill for a psychology professional. Again, this is what will make us professionally unique. Tayo lang ang may kaya ng psychometrics. Our ability to administer, understand, or interpret psychological tests or even make psychological tests, very big time skill set that all, let me repeat, all psych majors or psychology professionals should understand. Number two, psychometrics is a science. Alam nyo, as we are going to discuss next episode, psychometrics is not a random thing that we do. Hindi pwedeng kahit sino na lang gagawa ng psychometrics, and I think that's the reason why the government requires a license for anyone who will practice psychometrics. So kahit psych major ka, hindi ibig sabihin nun automatic, pwede ka mag-psychometrics. You have to study technical terms. You have to study scientific processes on how psychometrics work. And that will be the point of our lecture series for this libreng sit-in. Pag-aaralan natin yung mga scientific principles behind doing psychometrics. What are the most important concepts in psychometrics? Paano ba ginagamit yung mga concepts na yon para maging maayos yung proseso ng psychometrics? We will all discuss that as we go along. And last one, number three, psychometrics, I would say, is a prerequisite to functioning psychology professional. Ibig sabihin, if you call yourself a psychology professional, ibig sabihin yung trabaho mo may kinalaman sa psychology. The thing is, hindi pwedeng sasabihin mo na, well, I don't do psychometrics. No. If you are a psychology professional, along the way, at some point, you are going to use psychometrics the right way. So wala kang kalusot-lusot dito. Kahit ano pang ginagawa mo as a psychology professional, whether you are in the clinical setting, HR, or education setting, definitely, you need to have an above average level of knowledge of psychometrics. And I hope itong series of lectures natin sa psychometrics makatulong in achieving that goal for you to have an above average knowledge of psychometrics. Number four, sinabi ko na rin nga kanina to, psychology, actually ito psychology in general na to, no, is not a random field. I hope you realize, I hope you can appreciate yung field ng psychology never says anything without basis. In the context of general psychological knowledge, yung mga sinasabi natin about how the mind works, it's all based on scientific research. But when we try to say something about an individual person, tungkol sa kanyang mental health, tungkol sa kanyang personality, tungkol sa kanyang intellectual capacity, we follow the same principle. We don't say anything about a person in the individual level without any basis. And the basis that we use to prove that what we say about an individual person is correct. Genius ito. Ito hindi genius. Ito dapat i-accelerate na sa grade 3 from grade 1. All of those statements will be justified by what we will get from doing psychometrics. So sana na-appreciate nyo yung idea na yun, no, that we are not random here in this field. We always use basis, and the basis that we use is always following the scientific method. So that ends our short discussion for our context setting sa psychometrics. Abangan nyo yung mga next episodes natin where we are going to discuss important concepts in psychometrics for you to better understand and appreciate how the field works. Thank you for listening, everyone. Have a great day.